you'd make the team. Was that a weight off your shoulders after the trial?
Oh, definitely. Do you know the amount of lack of sleep I've had since then? it was just the relief, I guess, knowing that I've gone through so much and had to fight adversity, knockback, and everything you can think of to get to where I am now, and just to be part of this Olympics is just a fantastic achievement, and it's a dream come true of mine. So I'm so proud to be part of Team GB.
Tell me about the adversity.
I've mentioned, you know, being not being on funding last year. And the year before,
it was,
you know, any athlete will tell you not being on funding going into Olympic year is the worst thing that could happen. But thankfully for me, I got a lot of, you know, support from family, friends. You know, I'm a grinder, I work, so it bears no difference to me. If, you know, I see my rivals or other athletes around the world training full time, then that's good for them, but I know what I was capable of doing, no matter what I had to go through. So, you know, I didn't mind it. I just went along with it and dealt with it. Take each day as it comes, you know, and the most important thing was that I was healthy and, you know, I managed to have such a good season. And the other thing was, you know, my dad passing away in February, so that was...
Yeah. That must have been particularly tough.
Yeah, it was. It was very tough for me and my whole family. He went into hospital in Daegu, so I wasn't even able to see him and then speak to him. And he was in hospital ever since. And then he started to deteriorate in November. And then February, he just couldn't take it anymore.
Was it out of the blue or was it a...
No, he'd been suffering for a while. He had a long-term illness of he was a diabetic. He had heart problems, lung problems. My dad was an old guy, but he was so strong. And no matter what the outcome was of this year, he always said, like, Olympics is, he wanted it more than me, the dream, you know, the Olympics is everything you've worked hard for. So unfortunately, you know, he's not going to be there with me physically, but I know he's there with me all the time in spirit. So
is this part of the you making the squad for him then, really?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. And it was a hard process to go through. And I think the other big thing as well was I missed his burial in April. He was buried in Nigeria because I went to LA warm weather training. Right. So I kind of discussed it with my family and my mom and everyone else, and they just said, you know, there's no way, you're not giving up, you know, 3-4 weeks worth of training to go to bury your dad, because it was a lot emotionally, like I didn't know how I was going to cope. So they just said, listen, just keep doing what you're doing, and you know, just make sure you make the Olympics and get your spot. And you know, it's thankfully everything's just come to plan.
Really, I mean, there's no greater motivation, and there was no one who was going to take it from you. When you put it like that.
Yeah.
So tell me what you're most looking forward to, obviously, with all that behind you. And what are you most looking forward to about when it starts?
I'm most looking forward to like stepping out on the track and just that buzz, that feeling, that, you know, that euphoria. Because I've competed in championships before, but I've never been to a home nation's one, and I know the support here will be immense. I know there's a lot of people who are, you know, just as excited as I am about competing and being part of it. So I just couldn't be happier.
Given the emotion that obviously being a part of it that comes with it, what about those who didn't make it? Obviously the likes of Marilyn and stuff. Well, she did in the relay, but
yeah.
I mean, she missed out on the 800. What must be going through their minds right now?
I can't imagine what it's like for her.
Have you had a chance to speak to anybody?
I haven't. There was obviously a few rumours going around that there was going to be upsets, from what I remember, or from what I, you know, heard from Helsinki. I was good to go because obviously I had my individual. So it was, but when the team got announced, I found out, you know, the same time as you guys, and I was pretty shocked by, you know, people being left out, and you know, I'm sure there might be a few appeals. I don't know if it'll happen, whether they'll succeed or not. But I know Maz has got a great, you know, strength of character. Something like this won't knock her down. I know she's obviously said on Twitter, you know, I'm quitting and whatnot. But I know for the fact she won't. She's a very good friend of mine, and I know she'll, you know, bounce back from this.
What can Anika and Yura do in 100 metres?
A lot.
Take me through it.
100 metres, 200 metres. I intend to just... I get a big buzz from competing against world-class athletes. You know, going through the motions of the trials, it's exhausting, but I know my body, I know I'm fit, I'm robust, this is the healthiest I've ever been, and the cleanest I've had winter-wise. I've had no niggles, no injuries, no nothing. So, you know, I'm prepared to just go to battle with the rest of the world. I hope they're ready.
Can you deal with the hopes of a nation?
Yeah, why not?
Is that the good bit for you?
That is the good bit. Obviously, being a part of it, and you know, the next couple of weeks in the lead up to the Olympics is fantastic. But it's getting out there and going to war with the rest of the girls. There's no reason why I can't come out with a good performance just like them. So we'll see what happens.
Good luck with that.